Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll talk about the water and waste system on airplanes and what's that got to do with a vacuum cleaner. Or to say, how does an airplane deal with your s***? So let's get started.
1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, runway 27, minus 28.
This video is sponsored by Audible. Go to www.audible.com/CaptainJoe or click the link in the video description box below to get an exclusive 30-day free trial and a book of your choice for free. This is all you get to see as a passenger from the waste system, but there's more to it than just the toilet. The system consists of the following components: the sometimes not so clean toilets, meters of piping, a 170-liter waste tank, a couple of valves, a vacuum generator, a drain host connection, and servicing panels. So let's imagine we're in cruise and you've been to the toilet and you press the flush button. An electrical signal is sent to the flush control unit and it checks the airplane's current altitude. I am not kidding, it really does that, but I'll come back to that in a minute. Now the control unit opens up the water valve to rinse the toilet, and a second later you can hear the flush valve opening and sucking at your disposal. But the question is how? The waste system, the pipes and waste tank are constantly subject to suction pressure as there is a pipe leading to the outer skin of the airplane. So as soon as the flush valve opens up at the bottom of the toilet bowl, the differential pressure between the cabin pressure and the outer atmospheric pressure sucks and pushes the waste through the pipes to the waste tank. And that's one of the reasons why the toilet door has no door seals and a vent grid. Otherwise, the suction would be strong enough to suck out the air within the small toilet. So to get rid of a smelly odor, you might as well press the flush button a couple of times. And to clarify one ongoing rumor, no, your waste does not go overboard. Now let's say we're on ground and you're in the plane, but the flight is being delayed. However, you desperately have to go to the toilet. So after using the toilet, you press the flush button and the flush control unit registers via a pressure gauge that the plane is still on ground. That's what I meant earlier before with that it measures the altitude. So there is no differential pressure creating the necessary suction. And that's where the vacuum generator comes into action. The generator is electrically driven, similar to your household vacuum cleaner, and creates the suction pressure in the waste tank and pipes, so the toilet works no differently as if the plane were in cruise. So the next time you use the toilet on ground in the aft galley of an Airbus, check if you can hear the electrical motor of the vacuum generator once you press the flush button. But be aware, if you use the toilet whilst your colleague is shutting down the aircraft at a remote position, keep in mind that you need at least enough electrical power to flush the toilet. So in case there's no electrical ground power available, you would have to restart the APU for the flush sequence. And that will be your most expensive toilet visit ever, I promise you that. Also, the flush control unit shuts down the system once the waste tank is full or in case of a system failure. The waste and water level can be checked on the FAP, the forward attendant panel, and in case the waste tank is full, the flight attendant will notify the cockpit crew as they have no indication of the system in the cockpit. They then would request water waste service on a special service frequency via radio. Once the service truck arrives, a large hose is attached onto the servicing panel at the rear of the aircraft, and the drain valve is opened and the waste tank is sucked out empty within seconds. Another truck arrives and connects to the potable water hose point and refills the water tank. Now, the potable water system is entirely independent from the waste system, apart from the water which is used to rinse the toilet before the flush sequence. It consists of the following components: a 200-liter water tank, pipes leading to sinks and coffee makers, water heaters below the lavatory sink, a filling and draining port, and drain masts. During flight, part of the engine bleed air system is directed to the water tank to pressurize the entire system, creating the necessary power to push the water through the pipes so you can wash your hands in the lavatory sink. Below the sink sits an electrical water heater so you can choose from warm and cold water. Now, if you pay close attention, I mentioned beforehand a 200-liter water tank. independent from the waste system. So where does all the used water go? Now here comes a fact you might not have known. It all goes overboard. So once you wash your hands, the soapy water runs through the drain pipes to either the front or the rear part of the airplane, depending on which lavatory you've washed your hands, and exits the plane via the heated drain mast. Heated, obviously, to prevent the mast from freezing up. During winter operation, both systems need to be drained prior to longer grounding of the airplane to prevent the tanks from freezing up and damaging the pipes and other sensitive equipment within the plane. I hope you enjoyed this basic introduction video of the water and waste system of a passenger airplane. I have to say, this is obviously the knowledge of an A320 model, but the principle of the water waste system is fairly the same on most airplanes. So make sure to perform a touch and go at my Instagram account, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button plus the notification bell so you won't miss out upcoming videos. Thank you very much for your time. All the best, your Captain Joe. Please click onto the Audible link in the video description box below so you don't miss out this great opportunity on getting an exclusive 30-day free trial with Audible. I'm currently listening to the best-selling book by Brian Tracy called Goals. So it's a great audiobook giving you advice on how to set your goals, how to create daily habits helping you achieve your goals, setting up a book of visualizations and affirmations so you don't lose track of your goals is also included. To me, Audible is a great app. I can download the books I want to listen to and kick back after a long day of flying. And thanks to Audible, I got this book for free using my 30-day free trial. So make sure to check it out at www.audible.com/Captain Joe, because there's always something new you can read, listen, and learn.